Aviation or on ship?
Ship.
Yep. Cool. I was an old 130 driver. You've probably been in the back of a C-130
in your life. Oh, yes. Jumped out of it.
Yeah.
Perfect. Good airplane.
Good. So we're at old Marines, twice every day. Kid was killed in December of 10, down at a place called Orange Grove, right outside of Corpus Christi. He got dogging. And how I got involved, I knew his grandma. Mm-hmm. And he had this black lab that he just idolized, his dog, and named Eli. So anyway, right before he deployed, he told his mom that he was going to, you know, when he finished up his tour, he was going to come back to Orange Grove and raise puppies with Eli. So anyway, he got killed with a small arms fire. His grandmother called me and said, "Hey, will you see if we can get Eli back? Because that's the only connection, you know, family had." And I said, "Sure." You know how the Marine Corps is.
Sure.
Sometimes it can be a little rigid.
They aren't known for that.
So anyway, I called. I had a friend who was a Marine sergeant. Retired, that worked with me up in D.C. And so I said, "Here's the details, 3-5, this is the company, this is the boy, here's the dog, let's see if we can get it back." So he called me back in about 10 days and goes, "The way it works." I said, "Okay, it's not the answer I want." So I started going up the chain. Ended up, my best friend from college, who lives 200 yards out the front door of our house right now, is a lieutenant general, or was, lieutenant general of the Marine Corps. And so he had introduced me to a lot of those guys, and I went to Afghanistan and Iraq multiple times as a governor to go see our troops. And the commandant, Jim Connell, at that time, and I knew Jim because he had briefed me as he was S3 at the Pentagon, so I just called him the commandant. I said, "Hey, Jim, that's Rick Perry." So we had a nice visit, and I told him, I said, "Look, I don't know a lot, but I know if the commandant of the Marine Corps says something's going to happen." And I said,
"I'll open doors."
I said, "I'm asking for a chip." And I explained it to him. He said, "Let me work on it." And about 2 weeks later, he called me up, and he said, "Eli is on military transport en route to Cherry Point, with a stop headed to Lackland Air Force Base, San Antonio, with the instruction to don't put anything on him except 11 inches." So we delivered Eli to the Rusk family, and a year ago, last May, he sired his first set of puppies.
Okay.
So anyway, it's a sad story, but a good story.